Welcome to BioVivacious. BioVivacious is a YouTube channel dedicated to clear fundamental concepts of biosciences. A textbook will speak about four levels of protein structure. The primary structure is the sequences of amino acids and the covalent modifications such as disulfide linkages, phosphor relation, etc. If the secondary structure speak about the geometry that the primary structure adopts. So therefore we speak about the alpha helical structure, the beta platelet structure, along with that the beta turns, polyproline structures and the 3-10 helices. Basically, if the secondary structure of a protein is decided by the sequences of amino acids, which all amino acid can be present in the secondary structure, that determines how the folding occurs. We know very well that proline is an exception, so that can hinder with the structure. And these basic units, these basic foldings, it becomes something called a super secondary structure or the elements of secondary structure. The elements of secondary structure is somewhere in between the secondary structure and the tertiary structure. These are localized foldings. These elements of secondary structures are also known as motifs. We are going to discuss about motifs or elements of secondary structure. What exactly is this motif? So this is going to be our discussion today. Structural motifs are part of a larger protein domain. What happens in the structural motif is the alpha helical structure as well as the beta platelet structure will pack together. If the R groups, if the side chains are packed together and it becomes a compact structure. And they are formed for probably for several functions. Maybe to bind with the other proteins or to bind with the DNA molecules. Maybe to bind with the metal ions. They may have a very, very definite role to play in a protein structure. There are several examples of these super secondary structures, which are some of these examples which we will be looking at today. So the examples can be, it can be helix, turn helix, it can be EF hand, it can be beta structures like jelly rolls, Greek key, it can also be either beta, alpha, beta structures. So these are some examples of the super secondary structure we will be focusing on. Let us look at the first type of super secondary structure, which are called helix, turn helix. So therefore, as the name suggests, there is a helix, then there is a turn, there is another helix. It means that there will be two alpha helical structures. So therefore, one alpha helical structure, you also have a second alpha helical structure, and these two helical structures are joined with the help of a turn. So this is the basic structure of a helix, turn helix, which is very commonly found in proteins. What is the most important aspect of this helix, turn helix is, this is capable of binding with the DNA. For example, if you have a DNA structure this way, in these major grooves, this helix turn helix will go and bind. So therefore, the helix turn helix will bind at the major grooves. And it can modify the activity of DNA structure. So this is one type of super secondary structure that are found. In the second category of super secondary structure is helix, loop helix. Okay, helix, loop helix. They are slightly different from the helix, turn helix. So, what is the difference? In the helix, turn helix, it is a short turn which will differentiate or which will separate the two helices. Whereas in the case of helix, loop helix, it is a long loop which will segregate two helices. One classic example is what we call the EF hand. You will find EF hand very prominent in Cal moduli, in troponin C, etc. So in these two protein molecules, calmodulin and troponin C, in the role of the EF hand is to bind with the calcium ions. What it does is the EF hand, it will exactly look like in the right hand. If you keep your right hand in this way, this is the shape of the EF hand. So this is an alpha helical structure and this is called the E. And the thumb is the F, and you will see that there is a crevice made between the alpha E and the F. This is a long loop. You will find in the long loop structure amino acids like two aspartic acids, one glutamic acid and one asparagine. And these amino acids will make, along with the backbone of the helices, the carbonyl carbon, which is capable of binding to this calcium ions. So therefore, one helix is here and this is the another helix, a loop is formed here, and in this loop, calcium ions can be bound. If you look at the structure of calmodulin, there are four such helices. Let us draw the structure of calmodulin. One pocket, second pocket, third pocket and the fourth pocket, they are linked together. So first pocket, second, third and the fourth pocket. Each of these pockets has got an EF finger and it is capable of binding to calcium ions. And once it is bound to calcium ions, it is capable of modifying activities of a protein. This is how a helix loop helix operates. After understanding alpha helices, let us look at the beta structures. Now, if you consider this as a beta sheet, you can fold this beta sheet in this manner and it can become a cylindrical structure like this. It is just by folding the beta sheet we have created this structure. Now in this structure we know that it can have hydrophilic as well as hydrophobic amino acids. And by and large, the hydrophobic amino acids will be pointed inside the cylindrical structure. And the hydrophilic may be pointed towards the outside. This is the second kind of super secondary structure that I formed. Now these beta sheets, this cylindrical structure can be made of maybe about 4 to 10 beta sheets will help in forming this kind of a cylindrical structure. There are three kinds of structures that are found in a protein super secondary structure. If the three structures are, one is called a Greek key and the second is called either up and down arrows. In the third is called either jelly rolls. They are all made up of the beta platelet structures. How they are different? There will be very slight variation within the structure. How are they different? Let us look at each one of these structures. Let us see how these are arranged. In the first one, in the second one, the third one, and in the fourth one. Let us also number these anti-parallel strands. So, number 1, 2, 3, and 4. This is how we are numbering them, they are all connected by loops, simple alpha helical loops. Therefore, first one is connected, this is the way, here it is connected, and this is connected like this. This kind of an arrangement will give rise to something called a Greek key model. Basically, this is a linear structure. If you have to arrange 1, 2, 3, 4, this is 1, we have seen it, okay, number 1, and 1, it's arranged again. This is number 2, it is arranged through a loop. Number 2 is arranged to 3, this is 3, another loop. This is arranged to a fourth one using another loop. In a way, 1, 2 and 3 loops will link the 4 beta strands and it forms a Greek key structure. This is generally found within the protein framework. The second structure is the up and down barrel. In the up and down barrel, the difference is it has got 8 antiparallel structures. How are these 8 antiparallel structures arranged? So let us draw the structure. How are these 8 structures arranged? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So this is how they are antiparallelly they are arranged. Now the link is using a simple hairpin. So we begin from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is how it is arranged. Now this can be folded, as we have seen earlier. This can be folded and to give a cylindrical structure. This is how up and the down barrel operates. Now in this cylindrical structure, there is a classic example. That is the retinol binding protein. It has got up and down barrel. Retinol binding protein, you know, it is a single polypeptide chain made up of roughly about 182 amino acids. And the responsibility of this protein is to transport retinol. Retinol is a hydrophobic molecule, vitamin A, alcohol. It has to be transported from its storage site, which is liver, to wherever vitamin A is required. Now, how to transport this hydrophobic molecule? Therefore, this kind of a cylindrical structure, up and down barrel, is formed as part of the protein structure. If the entire retinol is trapped in between, safely protected, this is how the retinol binding protein will transport vitamin A to where it has to act. Beautifully carried out by our body. Another important super secondary structure is the jelly roll. Jelly roll is slightly complicated. This also has 8 sheets. How these sheets are, beta sheets, how these 8 beta sheets are arranged? You will find, first of all, let us draw the 8 sheets. So sheet number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. What is important is to know that number 1 and 8 are arranged closely. This is number 1 and this is 8 arranged closely. Number 2 and 7 are arranged closely. Number 3 and 6 are arranged closely. What is left now is number 4 and 5. 4 and 5. So this is how they are arranged. Let us see how they are connected by using turns. The turns are, the first one has to be connected to 2. This is connected this way to 2. 2 is connected to 3. 3 is connected to 4. 4 is connected to 5. 5 is connected to 6. Okay. 6 is connected to 7. 7 is connected to 8. You see the connection it establishes and it forms a very complex structure. This is another kind of super secondary structure which is found in the protein, that is called the Jelly rolls. So we have seen three kinds in this. One is the Greek key, up and down barrel, as well as the jelly roll. The last category of super secondary structures are called beta, alpha, beta motifs. This is the last category. So as the name suggests, there is alternate arrangement of beta structure with alpha structure followed by another beta structure. There are two classic examples of this kind of arrangement. One is what we see in the triosphosphate isomerase structure. It forms the beta and the alpha forms a kind of a beta alpha barrels. You will find that the structures are either barrels or it is forming. It forms a barrel. You will see that the beta structures, beta sheets are inside. It forms, this is beta sheets, about 8 of them forms the center core, surrounded by the alpha helical structure. You will find about 8 alpha helical structure surrounding it, and it forms a beta alpha barrel. This is one structure which is very commonly seen in protein. This also has a slight variation, and that variation, if one portion of it opens, it forms something called a horseshoe barrel. A part of it will be open. Another kind of structures which is very commonly found in protein is what we call a Roseman fold, in honor of the person who discovered this structure. If the Roseman fold is can be shown in the following manner. Let us draw the structure. This is how the Roseman fold is normally arranged. Let us number these. Number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the beta sheets. They are separated by the alpha helical structure. And it is arranged into two units. One unit and the second unit. Let us see how the linking occurs. We begin from here, one connected to alpha helical structure using hairpins. Now, if the 3 has to be connected to 4, so you can see that it is getting connected to 4 alpha helical, it continues. This is how a Roseman fold is formed. Basically, we have looked at the kind of structural motifs. The first one is the alpha turn helix. So in that we have seen the two types, turn as well as the loops. In the second category, that is in the beta sheets, we have seen three types. That is the Greek key, jelly rolls, and the up down arrow. Then finally the third type. In the third type is beta barrels, beta alpha barrels. In that we have seen two types. One is the alpha-beta barrel, which is normally seen in the triosphosphate isomerase enzyme. We have seen a variation in that called the horseshoe structure. And finally, we have seen how the Roseman fold is formed. These are some of the super secondary structures. Now, understand that these super secondary structures, they will join together and it forms part of domain of a protein. And then this is how the hierarchy of a protein is being arranged.